The international community urged to do more to protect journalists. The appeal made during a forum on media freedom and sustainability that was co-hosted by the U.S. State Department with the Netherlands. Panelists asked the global community to reduce the vulnerability of independent media to closure or political capture. Among the speakers, Sana Safi, senior presenter at BBC News, Bai Fang, president of Radio Free Asia, and U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken.
Governments are using libel, defamation, and counterterrorism laws to go after reporters who shine a spotlight on corruption and abuse. At the Summit for Democracy this week, we're asking governments to make concrete commitments to strengthen free, independent media and help tackle the diverse challenges that they face.
Blinken says America will make the biggest contribution to the newly launched International Fund for Public Interest Media. This aims to provide aid to independent news outlets at risk. The U.S. will also launch a new liability fund to support journalists and news organizations that are targeted with litigation as a result of their reporting. Several Philippine news organizations are facing libel charges from Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi after they reported on a graft complaint against him.
The old gatekeepers, journalists, have just been replaced by the new gatekeepers, technology. And for some reason, we have allowed lies laced with anger and hate to actually spread faster and further than facts.
Hostile governments and crony businesses are taking over independent news organizations, a phenomenon known as media capture. In some cases, media companies have been shut down. The Philippine government has denied a franchise to ABS-CBN, the largest TV network. It is now no longer able to broadcast on terrestrial channels.
The camp of presidential hopeful Ferdinand Marcos Jr. apologizes for the heavy traffic caused by his caravan in Quezon City Wednesday. As Jackie Manaba tells us, the campaign sortie of the Marcos and Sara Duterte tandem pushed through despite the lack of coordination with the local government.
Maraming salamat sa inyong pagdating.
A caravan of supporters of presidential aspirant Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. and his running mate, Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte, triggered Carmageddon. Along Commonwealth Avenue in Quezon City Wednesday, the traffic mess was due to the failure of the event's organizer, lawmaker Mike Defensor, to coordinate with the Quezon City government. Despite the lack of coordination, Quezon City still provided assistance to the caravan by deploying traffic enforcers, medical on standby, and policemen. It took the caravan 3 hours to traverse Commonwealth and another 2 hours to reach the endpoint at Welcome Rotunda, the boundary between Quezon City and Manila. Defensor is also running for mayor of Quezon City. He previously claimed that incumbent Quezon City Mayor Joy Belmonte denied the Marcos Duterte tandem to conduct a campaign sortie at the Liwasang Aurora inside the Quezon Memorial Circle. But the local government asserts the group was not allowed to use the park because it is tagged as child-friendly and children are not yet vaccinated. Quezon City instead offered the QC Gymnasium. The Marcos camp apologized to motorists for traffic congestion caused by the caravan, saying they were overwhelmed by the number of supporters who showed up for the event. The Marcos camp also thanked the Quezon City government for deploying policemen, traffic enforcers, and ambulances. Partido Reforma, the political party of presidential aspirant Senator Panfilo Lacson, meanwhile criticized the mass caravan for causing massive inconvenience to the riding public and motorists despite December 8 being a holiday. The party urges the Interior Department and the Commission on Elections to take a look at the issue. Quezon City is the most vote-rich city in the country. Marcos and Sara's father, President Duterte, won there in the 2016 polls. Jackie Manabat, ABS-CBN News.
the Interior Department to look into possible violations committed during the Marcos Duterte caravan in Quezon City. Interior Undersecretary Martin Dino says event organizers may be held liable for putting the public at risk, as the caravan was a potential COVID super spreader. He also cited the massive traffic jams it caused. Dino says the Commission on Elections and Pandemic Task Force officials should also make a stand against this and other similar political gatherings.
Hindi ba nila naisip na isang tao lang ang positive dyan sa ano, sa rally na o kung ano man yung inaano nila, magagamot ba nila? Pinakamalaking pananagutan ito yung kandidato, kaya lang kami sa DILG ang tinitignan namin dito yung organizer, kasi yung kandidato obligasyon niya ng COMELEC. Kayo nasa COMELEC, kung kayo may pagmamahal din sa ano, magsalita kayo. Kaya ngayon ang interagency task force dapat tignan nilang mabuti yan. Kung kayo ay dapat kumilos ang interagency task force tungkol diyan sa bagay na 'yan. Palagay ko at obligasyon nila 'yan. At saka Department of Health, magsalita kayo.
While the Marcos Duterte tandem were parading around Quezon City on Wednesday, a new alliance was formed against the presidential candidacy of the late dictator's son. It includes opposition coalition Isambayan and presidential aspirant Leonie de Guzman. De Guzman says he's even open to the possible unity talks with another opponent, Vice President Lenny Robredo, as he considers Bongbong Marcos their common enemy. But he insists he has no plans of backing out of the race to Malacañang.
Ayoko nang masyado pang pagsasagutin yung mga pwede ba para, kasi pwede namang kaming dalawa o kung sino man ang makapag-usap at doon na namin detalyehin. Ayoko nang, kasi pagka baka baka maging isa pinang Lenny Leo dito. Open akong makipag-usap. Sana ay magkaroon din ng klarong mga tindig doon sa issue ng mga mamayan.